My name is Anne-Marie Concepcion from InDesign Secrets. I want to show you in this video a few different ways to quickly flow in a lot of text into your layouts. Now, the document that I'll be using for experimenting is this starter file for Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. It has a title page, and then we want to start placing chapter one on this right-facing page. I just have a few empty pages here, and then we have the last page of the document has a text frame on it with some text just to represent some additional text later on in the document. So you'll see what happens when you autoflow. Let's go back to where we want to start placing the text. And that's the key word here, is that you want to place, not copy and paste, because then none of these tricks will work. So you need to choose File Place, which means Import. If you're using the new Properties panel, you'd click Import File button. And here is the file that we want. I'm going to turn off Replace Selected Item. And I'm just going to make sure that we're not bringing in any styles. That's turned off. So that's good. Click OK. And now we have what's called a loaded text frame. Now, the manual way that I think everybody knows is that you click once to create a frame, and now here's the overset text that's not placed yet. So you click on that overset marker with your selection tool. It loads the overset text. You go to some other place in the document, click again, and you go so on and so on. Well, this could be pretty onerous if you have like a 300-page document. So we're going to undo, and let me show you a couple alternative ways to do what I just showed you. Instead of just clicking, what you could do is hold down the Option key or the Alt key if you're on Windows. Look at the cursor, how it turns into like a little snake with half of it filled in. And I Option or Alt click, and what is different? Well, the cursor looks a little different. It's telling me that I have already clicked on that overset marker and loaded up the extra text. That's what Option or Alt clicking on the overset button does. It automatically saves you that step. So now you still have to continue to hold down the Option or Alt click every time you click, and then you can just click Option Alt click, Option Alt click. You don't have to look around and try to get that little red box every time. So that's kind of neat, and it's useful if you need to have a story continue in different places of your document that jump all over the place. So you can just scroll through, zoom out, and Option or Alt click wherever you'd like. Now, a faster way would be to hold down the Shift key. And now that little S-curve turns solid, and I Shift click, and it automatically adds all the text in my cursor, adding pages as necessary. So here's the last text frame of the story. And notice that it just ran roughshod over that existing text that we have right here. So it pays no attention. It'll go and fill in all pages, adding pages as necessary. So it's probably not a good idea to autoflow with the Shift key if you already have content in the document. You want to start after that content, or have it be the first thing that you do before you start adding content to additional pages. But it's great, like if you just have a one-page document, you Shift click on the first page, and bam, you have 200 pages added with all the text already flowed. Now, there's another little known feature. Let me go back up to our beginning. Let's say, let's zoom out a bit, that we don't want to add any new pages, but we do want InDesign to autoflow the text as much as it can. What I could do is hold down the Shift key and the Option or Alt key, and then you get a downward pointing arrow. And this is called semi-flow, something like that. And you, again, hold down these two keys, click once, and it auto-flows the text running roughshod over any existing content, but does not add any new pages. This is ideal if you have a limited number of pages in your document. You only have an 8-page newsletter, for example, and you want to place a long story, it will not add any more pages. Then you just have to go in there and edit it or format it to fit. Another way to auto-flow text has nothing to do with holding down extra keys. And instead, that's using the feature that has been built into InDesign for the last couple versions called Smart Text Reflow. It's here in Preferences under Type. I have it turned off by default. I don't know if it's turned off by default for everybody, or if I did this long time ago when I first installed InDesign. But Smart Text Reflow will automatically auto-flow long text frames if a certain criteria is met, and you don't have to hold down any special keys. So I've turned this on. I'm going to turn on Add Pages to End of Story, and I'm going to leave all these off, and then click OK. So how does this work? Let's zoom in a bit again. I'll come back up here to page one. I'll place that same story, click open, and okay. And now I'm not holding down any special keys, I just click once. Now where's the magic? The magic is not happening. Well, the key is the criteria that have to be met is that Smart Text Reflow won't kick in unless you have two text frames at least that are threaded on two separate pages. So now that I do that once, I wait a second, and ta-da, it adds pages as necessary, and it does not overset or run over any kind of existing content. It's pretty cool that way. So that's you don't need to use primary text frames here in preferences. It's under type. That's why I've turned that off. You don't need to have all that kind of stuff set up. And you can experiment with some of these different settings if you'd like. But I just want to show you that there's no need to try to get your cursor over that little marker and flow long text files yourself. You can do it on your own with any of these features that I just showed you. Now, I hope you like this tip, and if you want to learn more tips, please visit us at InDesignSecrets.com and subscribe to InDesign Magazine.